So your question is, individual has also his own thoughts, vikshepa. So we are speaking of Ishwara Shristi. Ishwara is Lord. And in the Lord, you are also a Jiva. You are also Brahman, no? Ishwara can create something, you also can create something, no? Only Ishwara creates a beauty and you create a mess out of that. So, right now we are speaking of Ishwara Shristi. Please understand, everything in Ishwara Shristi is beautiful. There is no ugliness in the Ishwara Shristi. Ishwara Shristi includes Panchabhutas, the sky, okay, the wind, the fire, the water, the earth, the universe consisting of various laws, perfectly working. The sun, the moon, the plants, the living beings, it's all Ishwara Shristi. It's perfection. In that, Jiva is created, which is you. Okay? In Jiva, Brahman forgets himself. Now becomes Jiva Shristi. Jiva Shristi is your individual creation. What is your individual creation? What is the difference between Brahma Shristi or Jiva Ishwara Shristi and Jiva Shristi? What is the difference? You understand the question? What is the difference? Ishwara Shristi is an objective reality for all of us. Jiva Shristi is a subjective reality for you. You understand? Subjective example here. I am angry. I am afraid. Can somebody else see your anger? Can somebody else see your fear? It's your private locked in your head somewhere. Okay? Why you are able to create that? You are also Brahman, no? You are able to create using Ishwara Shristi. You are projecting your own Shristi there. You understand? You are actually Ishwara Shristi is there, which is very beautiful. I mean, of course, water is polluted now because of Jiva Shristi. Otherwise, what will happen? Everything is beautiful in Ishwara Shristi creation. That's objective reality. See, if you ask, if I ask you, what is reality? You'll always point to some objective reality. You have a subjective reality also. What is that? Fears, anxiety, anger, jealousy, which is a subjective reality. Okay? Can the subjective reality can be seen by somebody else? Of course, unless you go and hit somebody. Right? Unless you show through your body emotions, nobody can understand. It's locked within your head. You understand? It's subjective reality. It's your own reality, individual reality. Why you are able to create individuality? Because you are Brahma. Understand? You are also Brahman only. Right? The Ishwara creates the entire universe because he is Brahma. You create your own mental universe because you are Jiva. That includes your ambitions, that includes your desire, that includes your anxiety, that includes your own concept of me. How did you create that? Using your thoughts. Right? So, do you understand the word called all thoughts are unreal? Why the thoughts are unreal? They are in your private mental space. They are apparent disappear in your mental space. Okay? They are not objective reality, which is Ishwara Shristi. It's called Pratipasika reality or your mental space. Your dream is your private property. Okay? Whereas this objective universe is the Ishwara Shristi. In the Ishwara Shristi, you create Jiva Shristi. Okay? In Mukti, Jiva Shristi disappears, dissolves. Ishwara Shristi remains. You understand? In Mukti, Ishwara Shristi doesn't disappear. Jiva Shristi disappears. Your mental concepts, your mental ambitions, your mental fears, they are resolved in Jiva, in Mukti. Don't think that Ishwara Shristi will disappear. Are you getting what I'm saying?
bringing this memory thing. Okay. The memory manifests as private thoughts, right? See, this, you know, what I understood was our fears, desires, suffering, all this, they have their own life and death.
Right.
They rise and die. So in this process, if you, the moment, suppose you are in fear or in sorrow or suffering, the moment you observe it, it dissolves.
Correct.
And it dissolves and it gives you sort of...
No, relief.
Relief and it's a joy. Basically, it's a...
Ananda.
Ananda.
Mm.
The ananda keep manifesting.
Right.
When you start observing these creations.
Yes.
So that's not, I think it can be...
No, I think you are jumping the question.
Yes.
So this question will come now. Tena tektena bujita means what is the meaning of that, I'll tell you.
Sure.
Right? So right now, understand the difference between Jiva Shristi and Ishwara Shristi. Ishwara, Jiva Shristi is your own private universe. Okay? So please understand in your private universe, you create an image of Ishwara Shristi in you. You have a mental image. Okay? Many times we talk to ourselves, right? Shouting at our boss. Where is the boss? That fellow is somewhere else. But you have created an image of the boss in your head and you have created an image of yourself and these images are talking. And obviously you can't do that because you are Brahma. Who stops you from doing that? Now the question is, as Brahma, are you creating the right image or wrong image? It's your choice. You want a nice movie or horror movie? It's your choice. ರಮಣ ಪ್ರಕಾರ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಜೀವ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಈಶ್ವರ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ ಅಂತ. ಈಶ್ವರ ಈಸ್ ದ ಇನ್ ದ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ ಅಂತ. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಇನ್ ಡೀಪ್ ಸ್ಲೀಪ್ ಯು ಗೋ ಟು ಈಶ್ವರ ಅನ್ಮ್ಯಾನಿಫೆಸ್ಟೇಜ್ which includes the world and your Shrishti. So when it's projected, you project it both in waking state. Ishwara and Jiva both are projected from the waking state. So first Jiva is projected as I thought. That's all. If there's no I thought, then the Jagat is not there. So Jiva and Jagat are projected together by Ishwara when you wake up. Jagat consists of Ishwara. Okay? Jagat consists of Ishwara and Jiva. Jagat and Jiva both are projected by Ishwara. And Jiva is nothing but I thought. So that gets projected when you wake up. Understand? It's not that you as a Jiva creating it. That Ishwara is projecting it. Right? Ishwara is projecting you as a Jiva also. You are also being part of the projection. Right? Any questions? So that's why we have to always have our thinking creates our reality. Okay? You have learned a lot of unconscious thinkings in your life. You have to correct with the right thinking, which is actually based on Vedantic teaching. The whole purpose of Vedantic teaching is to understand. So the contemplation means correct your thinking, right thinking. Then your Shrishti, Jiva Shrishti becomes Jiva Shrishti changes. Understand? Otherwise, Jiva Shrishti will continue unconscious living. Based on, in unconscious living, you don't have control. It's already lost control because you have forgotten that you are Brahma. Come back to a conscious creation based on Shravana Manana. Manana means understanding. Contemplation. That means wrong thoughts which you have acquired, you have to correct with the right thoughts. Okay? Which are pointing to Brahman. Wrong thoughts are always pointing to object. So you have to correct every thought to Brahman. That's called contemplation.